The second type of ecology is urban ecology. Urban ecology is related to the study of urban areas, cities and towns, where the urban areas are studied. It is urban ecology. Urban ecology deals with the relationship between man and environment of cities and towns. Here, the relationship between man and environment in the cities is studied. Because of its interdisciplinary nature and unique focus on humans and natural systems, the term urban ecology has been used variously to describe the study of humans in cities, of nature in cities, and of the coupled relationship between human and nature. So it is the study of the human beings in a city, the nature in a city, and the interrelationship between the human beings and the nature in the cities. It is the study of community structure and organization as men in cities and relatively as manifested in cities and relatively dense human settlements. And the third one is rural ecology. Rural forests are therefore social ecological systems that contribute to ecosystem and landscapes. Configuration. Definition of rural territories and sustainability of local livelihoods. So the study of the rural areas, their forest, their livelihoods, their human beings are all part of rural ecology. Rural ecosystem reflects the suitability of rural regional status to the production and living activities, and it also reflects the character, functions, position and the role of rural areas as well as its population, resources and environment. Then ecosystem. Human beings, animals and plants are living components of the universe. The environment is inorganic. Non-living component of this system includes heat, energy, land, water, bodies, temperature, gases, etc. These are all non-organic components of the ecosystem, and the human beings are the organic components of ecosystem. Ecosystem is interrelationship of these two components. So the inorganic and organic components interrelationship is the study material of ecosystem. It is that community or groups of living organisms that live in and interact with each other in a specific environment. So how a community or group of living organisms interact with the interact in the environment with the other factors. An ecosystem includes all of the living things, plant, animal and organisms in a given area interacting with each other and also with their non-living environment, that is weather, earth, sun, soil, climate, atmosphere, etc. So how in an ecosystem, how the living organisms interact with each other and how they interact with non-living environment is the main focus of study. Usually biotic members of an ecosystem together with their abiotic factors depend on each other. Ecosystems are the foundation of the biosphere and they determine the health of the entire earth system. Then comes environment. Everything which surround in is called environment. All the things that are present in at the place where we are living or we are surrounded with is called as environment. It includes both ecological and geographical conditions. It is total web of life which includes physical characteristics of a particular region as well as plants and animals. So the physical characteristics of a region, plants and animals that are found in a particular region constitutes the environment. Environment is a place where different things are, such as a swampy or hot environment. It can be living, biotic or non-living, abiotic things. It includes physical, chemical and natural forces. Living things live in their environment. They constantly interact with them and adapt themselves to conditions in their environment. So all the living things, they are in contact with different things that are present in the environment, and it is their way how they are adapting that particular environment is the main thing. In the environment, there are different interactions between animals, plants, soil, water, and other living and non-living things. Man-made environment is known as cultural environment. Traditions, folkways, language, beliefs, art and literature, social values are part of cultural environment. So the man-made environment includes your cultural environment. All your traditions, folkways, language, beliefs, art and literature are part of cultural environment. Social environment emerges from the interaction between biophysical ecology and human intervention. For example, the fertile soil of the Indo-Gangetic floodplain enables intensive agriculture. Its high productivity allows dense population settlements and generates enough surpluses to support other non-agricultural activities, giving rise to complex hierarchical societies and states. So wherever there are chances of prosperity because of the environment conditions, the people will settle over there, and the different social advancements and social problems will arise. Different relationships between environment and society also reflect different social values and norms, as well as knowledge systems. The multiple cultural meaning of a river, its ecological, utilitarian, spiritual, and aesthetic significance are stripped down to a single set of calculations about profit and loss from the sale of water for an entrepreneur. There are different perspectives of the environment and its relationship. relationship to society. These differences include the nature to nature debate. Theories and data about environment and society are influenced by the social conditions under which they emerge. So, whatever is the environmental perspective of a particular thing, when the entrepreneurs start interacting with that environment, in that case, everything, whatever cultural, spiritual, religious sentiments are there towards a particular thing in the minds of the human beings, they are all changed, and the monetary concepts gets involved in it, that is earning of profit. For example, water, the rivers, many of the rivers have their mythological importance in the Indian society, but when the river water is to be bottled and to be sold in the market, then only one thing is there, that is earning of profit. Thus, the notions that women are intrinsically less able than men and the black naturally less able than the whites were challenged as ideas of equality became more widespread during the 18th century, social and political revolutions. Geology, geography, botany, zoology, forestry, and hydraulic engineering are among the many disciplines that were created and institutionalized to facilitate the management of natural resources for colonial purposes. Complex industrial technologies and modes of organization require sophisticated management systems, which are often fragile and vulnerable to error.